Jared here with CarBuzz.com, and today I am at the Kennedy Space Center here in Central Florida, showing you the all-new 2020 Corvette convertible. First time ever on a Corvette. This one's going to be a little bit more expensive, $7,500 more than the base model, so about $67,000 gets you into a base Corvette convertible Stingray. Now let's go ahead and check out this blue car, which Chevy says is going to be their most popular color so far. So just like the coupe, we've got a 6.2 liter V8 engine under the hood. It's an LT2, sort of derived from the LT1 that was in the C7, but now it produces 490 horsepower, 495 actually, and 475 foot-pounds of torque. And that's gonna go out to the rear wheels only through an 8-speed dual clutch automatic. First time you've ever been able to get a dual clutch in the Corvette. And unfortunately, that means you're not gonna be able to get a manual. Some people on the internet are not happy about it, but that's what's gonna help get this car to 60 really quickly. The coupe does it in about 3 seconds. The convertible probably going to be a little bit heavier, but Chevy has not quoted performance figures just yet. We'll need to wait a little bit longer before we get those. So the biggest difference between this and the hardtop is the hardtop obviously has a removable roof as well, but that's going to be a manual one. You're going to have to take that off and store it yourself. For your extra $7,500, you're getting a power retractable hardtop, so it's all going to fold into an area here, give you a little bit more of an open space in here as well. And the big convenience there is you won't have to get out of the car to take off the roof. So as I mentioned, the big difference with the convertible is you won't have to undo. There's three in the front and one in the back. Once they're undone, the roof is pretty easy, but it is kind of a two-person job. So you'll have to decide whether that $7,500 is worth it to you, so you don't have to go through this process to take off the roof. All right, so this is my first time sitting in the new Corvette. We've got this interesting blue leather motif. There are a bunch of motifs that you can get on this car. This one's kind of cool. It matches the blue on the outside. The materials seem a lot better than what I've seen from other Chevrolet products. We have this very weird sort of square racing style steering wheel. Seems to fall pretty nicely into hand here. We've got our infotainment here. And of course, there are no gauges here. That is all screen. And now everybody, the internet has been ablaze talking about this big row of buttons. Seems like it would fall easily to hand, but it does definitely divide you from your passenger. So if your passenger has cooties, you are not going to be bumping elbows with them anytime soon. So switching to a mid-engine design, of course, not going to be quite as practical as the Corvettes used to be. They had that big glass hatch, but Chevy says you can still get two sets of golf clubs. So if you golf, you are going to be impressed with the storage capacity here. And even on this convertible model, they have designed the top in such a way that it won't take up any of your storage space. This is the rear storage space up here, and we also have that storage up in the front, if you want to call it a frunk. That's what Porsche people have been calling it for years, but this is the first time you're going to be able to say it on a Corvette. You may be able to fit two golf clubs in the back, but you're definitely not gonna fit two bags of golf clubs up here. But if you do have a briefcase or something extra, the Corvette's frunk will be handy. You know, if you just have some extra groceries or something like that. Again, not as practical as the front engine car with the hatchback, but pretty good for a mid-engine car. Chevy says the 2020 Corvette Coupe is going to enter production late in 2019, with the convertible model going into production in early 2020. So it'll be a little bit of a later availability on that one. This C8R race car, you're not gonna be able to take this one home for you, but it should be dominating America's racetracks very soon. Hope you've enjoyed this video. See you next time.